This might kill it, though. The injury goes fatal and the creature dies. Yay. Oh, there he is. After slaying the creature, you have to face the fact that you cannot save Archon Monterey from certain death. As you see how the vortex swallows him slowly, with the last remains of his power, he sends you a weak telepathic message. We have failed. I have tried to communicate with Lord Neon, but all the astral channels are totally deformed. You have to stop the Unborn. Its point of entry to this world is in the old cave at the western side of Mount Torch. Trust the Guardian. It will protect you when you step through the threshold of darkness. Mount Torch. Then the dying priest gathers his every strength to perform a long-range reality shift spell. Oh, is he teleporting me there? We gotta rest soon, though. We gotta rest first. Before anything else happens. Alright. All these values went back up. Awesome. Something like that. Being really careful, guys, because my manual saves, in case you missed the other episodes where I explained it. When I leave the emulator, they go away. Those saves go away. So, I've been doing save states and hope those work, because I think save states are problematic with this game. Because it's on WHD load or whatever. Is that... Where are we? Oh, the door is very well built. We're back to the beginning. Indicates correction facility. This is where we were interrupted when we first came in. This is the lobby. I didn't try to open the doors, but it looks like you can anyway. Yeah, I had read this stuff before. That's the way out. I didn't know there was another place to go. Mount Torch. As the information says, this door leads to the inner sanctum. You can't get that way. The message library, wing 1, 2, and 3 is written onto this one. I want to see the library. I want to read all the stuff. Imagine all the lore that could be added here. So where's Mount Torch? Wait a second. Stone Thorn Hills. Was it like over here or something? Flame Pool Lake. Oh, the foot of Mount Torch. You reach the top of this magnificent volcano. You are near a large crackle crackle at the dark side of Mount Torch. Oh. You carefully descend into the lightless crackle on the rocky side of the old sleeping volcano. For long, long moments, nothing happens, but then suddenly, the guardian starts to radiate, so extremely intense, glowing light that you have to cover your eyes with your hands. When you open your eyes again, you find yourself in another kind of existence. In the middle of nowhere, you feel as adrenaline bursts all over you, seeing the most bizarre, most wonderful, and most threatening sight you have ever seen and dreamed about in your nightmares. The majestic, shining fortress of steel, realm of the unborn, a symbol, a morbid creation of the collective subconsciousness, built between two dimensions, exactly as written in the prophecy. This eerie astral palace expands all over the horizon and up into the starless sky, hiding behind its surreal walls something entirely alien. Whoa. Steel is a man-made... It's a compound, though. It's not something found in nature, so I wonder why steel would be out here. Like, obviously someone created the steel, and then someone created the fortress. Whoa. After so many wasted lives, dangers, pain, and struggle, the Guardian has guided you here into this altered universe. This cosmic pool of tears wept by countless civilizations before their vanishing into nothingness. Hallucinations overrun you as this living organism of dreams, visions, and memories wakes up to entomb you into itself. Horrible cries of entire worlds damned and lost with millions and millions of souls. The unbearable, maddening experience of no beginning and no end, accompanied by chants of dark, twisted armies praising to their wicked god. Burning twilight whispers, "Join us! Join us! The unborn! Its presence is no threat anymore. It is so relaxing." "Yes, our universe is only a creation of our minds. Yes, we join you." Is that us saying that? Or the unborn? Then a light appears at the end of the tunnel as unbelievable energies cleave the gray mist of chaos around you. The blinding shine of the Guardian drives you back right from the threshold of darkness. Its ancient divine power forces the unborn to take vulnerable, substantial form. A few moments pass in this timeless void, and you are facing a god. Yeah, it's been real, guys. Yeah, morale, yeah. Seems fitting. Oh, we're in battle automatically. The battle begins with action order calculations and orientation. Can I talk to it? Who's this? Epsilon. Oh, that's it. Oh, we're all placed even spaces around it. That's interesting. Well, he'll hit it with a sword. See how that works out for him. He's unlimited again, right? Wow, it's like, yeah, in the middle of space. Complete nothingness around. I'm just gonna have him defend for now. I don't think speed needs to be increased anymore, but what the hell, I'll do it. It might help in the end. Does he have bandages? Let's see. Bandages. No. Okay. I think none of us have bandages. Yeah, his speed was affected. Like, he's lost speed permanently, that's weird. I mean, it probably is a bug that you can have unlimited speed, so maybe it just corrected itself somehow. I should be defending with mental, actually. The Unborn prepares for a physical attack. Defending mentally, I should. Eternal astral chaos? Defending mentally. Oh. Advent unaffected. Sweet. Its stamina is down by half almost. Paralyzed under the destructive mental influence. We might as well go right up to it. He's attacking the ones furthest away. Tunnel of spiritual void. He'll throw his boomerang at it. Might as well just get up to it. It's attacking the ones farthest away anyway, so it doesn't even matter. Oh, am I too close for... Damn it. I was wasted. What's that doing to them? Oh, Twin Snake. He has no intelligence and no sixth sense. Okay. Can you even fire a weapon with zero intelligence? It's like, what would you be? Like a babbling idiot then, right? Hopefully this is not going to hit Advent, right? Well, that's Varanus, actually. Missed. Yeah, it doesn't hit him. Okay. Just defend mentally, I guess. Oh, I should have got another attack up, actually. tunnel of spiritual void. Well, if they want to make it tough, they should have... It only attacks once a round. And there's only one of it. Unless this is not its final form kind of thing. I suspect that might be the case. Oh, well, looks like it does attack twice in a round. Yeah, it's attacking more. But so are we. It's got no stamina. Missed. Let's see. Will Epsilon land the killing blow with his broadsword? Balanced broadsword. The Unborn's dying avatar transforms into another shape. The Chaos Embryo creates a black hole. Epsilon suffers damage by the enormous local pressure level. Suffers damage by... It's attacking three... Yeah, this is its final form. I hope. It's got no intelligence and no something else. Yeah, no sixth sense and no intelligence. Wow. I don't know if there's anything to get that back. Still really being affected, at least by stamina. We can go again. The Chaos Embryo. This is insane. I mean, what else can be affected? His intelligence and the other thing, whatever, is already zero. Poor Epsilon. Intelligence and sixth sense, zero. Concentration is fine. Everything else is fine. His stamina is affected a little bit. Oh, his speed is down. Maybe that's part of intelligence? I don't know how, but... Well, I'm having a blast, though. Never fought a fetus before, at least. Pretty sure I haven't. This is... Killdozer going, I think? Yeah. Missed. Wow. This might even kill it. Oh, it's got a tiny bit of stamina left. And we might just get rid of that right now. The injury goes fatal and the Chaos Embryo dies. The party has successfully defeated the enemy. Awesome. After reaching the outside world again, you immediately initiate an emergency launch sequence on your sand glider ship's computer to get the Guardian out of the critical zone. before the dying Unborn attempts to destroy it with a final, desperate strike. Checking your sensor readings, you realize that you cannot put enough distance between you and the collapsing steel fortress to save your own lives as well. The background radiation level is so incredibly high that no living organism, including you, will remain alive within more than 200 miles of the radius. We're gonna die? The world will survive, you won't. But it doesn't really matter now. You're just standing proudly, silently watching the rear sight, watching as a second sun is rising on the horizon. Is there anything else? Is this the end? Is there anything else? I've been clicking mouse buttons. Maybe you can see that. Space. Enter. Oops, sorry about that, guys. I hit tab. That was weird. It moved the screen to the side and the music got all messed up. Escape. It's like you could picture credits rolling right now, but there's no credits. Is that normal? I think there's just nothing else after this. It's, not like dropping us back to a main menu or even dumping us back out to, like, Workbench or anything like that. I think that's the end. So I want to thank you guys for watching. This was an awesome game. Really would not have known about it other than I think I gave him a shout out in the episode 2, which was... Episode 1 was just the intro. Episode 2, Retrospective Gaming. Check him out. He did a review of this game, or maybe not so much a review, just talking about different aspects of the game. Yeah, Retrospective Gaming. He clued me into this game. And then after that, I saw some articles from CRPG Addict. So it's crpgaddict.blogspot.com. He's been reviewing games on his, well, doing playthroughs of games on his blog, I guess, and reviewing them at the end. Yeah, he has a rating system and everything. He's done 400-something games, and he's up to 1993, so... Which I think is when this game came out. Or it might have been 1992. And he just finished Amber Moon as well, so check that out. It's another game I really enjoy. So yeah, I want to thank you guys so much again. I hope to get to some more Amiga games in the future. Not completely sure when. So, a couple adventure games, and I do want to play Black Crypt, but I'm not sure when I'll get to that. Because, this has been running on the weekends, and I think the weekends is going to be Daggerfall now. And possibly Song of the Ocean as well. At least till those are done. And then we'll see what we want to add in. But yeah, if you guys enjoyed and you're still listening, not sure why anyone would be listening at this point, I do have a Patreon if anyone's interested in supporting the channel. I have a Ko-fi, Ko-fi, account as well if you like just want to send like a one-time donation, like a tip or something, like $2 I think it is. You can buy me a health potion to replenish us after fighting the Unborn. Very appreciated, but not required. I thank you guys for watching and your likes and comments as well. Very much appreciated. Yeah, this game is freaking awesome, and I'm going to remember this probably for quite a while, and until I get senile or something. Like, I think a follow-up is needed just to explain some of the lore. I mean, I'd love to read a novel set in this world, get into the Witch Masters of Carnivore and all these different dimensions and things and all these different gods, all these different societies and orders that they have set up, sand gliders and, you know, technology and magic and post-apocalyptic stuff. I find it all really interesting. Alright, so hope to see you guys in another Let's Play, and always, seek adventure.